Chronicle is closed captioned for the hearing impaired with a grant provided by Bull Worldwide Information Systems.
Tonight, say goodbye to full-time jobs, benefit packages, weekly paychecks. Say hello to tomorrow.
You're not going to find the same job at the same salary.
Corporate America is becoming extinct. Are you becoming a dinosaur? A taste of tomorrow's workplace.
An opportunity that was a negative at the beginning turned into a positive for us.
Laid off. They're selling their services back to their old bosses. And he's going it alone, building a one-man kayak with a one-man corporation. Will working without pay pay off for her?
It might evolve into some kind of a relationship.
If you're going to make it in the workplace of the 90s, you have to be creative, and you have to be prepared to sell yourself.
The Brave New World of Work, next.
Tonight, Peter Mohegan, Mary Richardson, with Liz Bruner and Mike Barnacle. Chronicle, New England's nightly news magazine.
Global competition. Defense cutbacks. Recession. They all add up to one thing.
Jet engine maker Pratt & Whitney is eliminating 10,000 jobs.
Digital Equipment Corporation is closing its Westminster plant.
GE announced today that up to 700 workers will lose their jobs.
In our history of this country, there's never been a more tumultuous period in the labor markets as what's happened in the last 5 or 10 years. We have thrown, it's literally like nuclear weapons, exploded nuclear weapons in our economy in the sense of the magnitude of the changes.
Besides recession and globalization, automation has also hit the job market. It has all meant such change for corporate America. Things may never be the same.
The idea of the corporation as we used to think of it in, say, in the 1950s or even the 1960s is probably something that we're not going to see again, at least for the remainder of this generation.
But what is this generation of downsized and decruited ex-employees doing? The smart ones are playing a whole new game.
I'm looking for an engineering job, basically in the civil, structural, and environmental fields.
The name of the organization is WIND, for Wednesday is Networking Day. Every week, hundreds of corporate refugees gather here in Wilmington. It's an incredible talent pool, made up mostly of former middle managers, a nearly extinct breed. They come for encouragement and hard leads.
They get a chance to talk to other people, not only in their own discipline, but in other disciplines.
Lee Kirkwood founded WIND 3 years ago.
People are recognizing the fact that they can't do this job search alone, that they need help, that they need to know that there are other people around them and feel good about that.
Every week you come and there's more people that you know that you've passed either as former customers, former suppliers, or former co-workers. So that kind of keeps you going too.
Members go through hundreds of job postings at the WIND Resource Center, and although few find the exact job at the exact pay they used to have, at least they learn what's needed in today's fickle market.
I also learned from WIND that looking for a job is a full-time job.
Every week there are success stories to share. A name card goes up on a bulletin board for every victory. This one took 9 months.
Networking is a key. Let me tell you, every time I go out to a group of people and I ask them, how did you get jobs? Networking by far is the winner. Because people like to help people also.
Most of the people who have lost their jobs through downsizing will probably never go back to the workplace as they knew it. Corporate America just isn't what it used to be. And for some corporate refugees, that's just fine with them. You've entered the world of Quantic, an Andover company that does corporate communications. Quantic was born 2 years ago when Digital decided to eliminate its own communications department. Rather than get on the unemployment lines, a core group formed Quantic. Now their best customer just happens to be their old employer. Steve Travis and Bob Morey were among the originals.
The whole concept of this was created to provide back to Digital some of the services that this internal in-house group used to have. One of the things we looked at was this spin-off opportunity or outsourcing opportunity.
Outsourcing, a practice that's changing the way America does business. Outsourcing means farming out everything but a company's central activity. So digital only does computers, and Quantic only does production.
We have a company whose prime business is the craft and the art and the trade that the individuals are in. The term I've heard before is all the wood behind one arrow, and that's very much the way we do business here.
There are almost 100 employees here, as opposed to 100,000 at Digital. It's not a big pond, but the people who came here think it's definitely better. In fact, with a customer base of over 200 companies, you could easily say this was a divorce made in heaven.
An opportunity that was a negative at the beginning turned into a positive for us.
Yes, there is life after downsizing. Just ask Paul Farrell, formerly an executive with an environmental corporation. He now heads what the experts call a virtual corporation. His company is Walden Paddlers, and his product is kayaks made of recycled plastic. So where are all the workers? Well, Farrell doesn't have a staff except for his son. Yet he is head of a so-called virtual corporation because of the way he operates.
Well, Walden Paddlers is a group of people who work together, and we're spread out all over the place. The designer of the boats is in upstate New York. The manufacturer who actually molds the hulls is here in Deerfield, Massachusetts. The packaging designer and producer for our recyclable, reusable packaging is in Rhode Island.
You might call it outsourcing to the max. By the time the hulls get to Farrow's Acton workshop, all they need is trim. After less than a year in business, it's unclear whether he'll make a fortune. But he knows he would have spent one if he had not gone solo.
Had no idea. I never heard of a virtual corporation until a month ago. This is just the way it worked out. It seemed to make sense, so we did it.
Resourceful people, outsourcing.
Yeah, there's a whole new language now, Mary. Actually, outsourcing is helping people reclaim jobs in a couple of different ways. One thing, even though their job may be gone, as we saw with Quantic, the need for the service may still be there. And in the case of Paul Farrow, he was able to start up an entirely new enterprise without a lot of upfront money, thanks to this new concept.
All right, and more of Chronicle in just a moment. Coming up next, job search strategy.
If you have to parachute down, if you have to submarine up, if you have to go in the back door, the side door, or every door you have to go in, you have to get in front of a potential employer.
For those who want to escape a gridlocked world, BMW has created the new all-season 325i convertible. It opens a whole new world, 365 days a year.
Call 1-800-334-4BMW to test drive the new 325i convertible.
Back after this.
Introducing Maximizer Loans from Bank of Boston. You get maximum flexibility and value for your money. Applying is easy, approval is fast. Become a Max or Portfolio 50 account customer and take advantage of low interest rates on personal credit lines, auto loans, and of course, home equity loans for home improvement. Maximizer Loans from the bank that's listening, Bank of Boston.
Up next, why temping is tempting.
You're in control of your 800 number now, and you can take it wherever you want. But why take a chance on sending it somewhere far away? Keep it here with New England Telephone, so you won't lose control of it. Now we can manage all your 800 needs with competitive rates and the reliability and service you can only get from your local phone company. Call us. We're the one for you, New England. New England Telephone, part of the 9X family.
Escape purchase at Filene's.
The job search of the 90s isn't what it used to be. It's not about finding a job like the one you just lost. It's about making it on your own.
And sometimes that means discovering new skills or changing fields or going it on your own. Rethinking is the first step to retraining for a new career.
What we're trying to train them for is to work in a Workforce 2000, which would be more on teams, being able to have what we call soft skills, which would be listening skills, communication skills, marketing skills, being able to market themselves.
Leslie Musselman calls this the new job reality. She's the director of the High Technology Center in Wilmington. The center is designed to provide a softer landing for professionals, jettisoned from Wang Labs and General Electric. They come for stress class, exercises in resume writing, to learn the 90s way of looking for a job.
Take risks. Don't just keep looking for that job that is the same job title in just a different company. Be creative about the options you look at. It's just, you're not going to find the same job at the same salary.
To the pink slip software engineer, technical writer, or CPA, this is indeed a whole new ball game.
What I did hear very loudly and clearly was, you have talents and skills that may have been hidden, buried, or unused in the past. Dare to dream.
Explore options. Look at all those doors and open them up and go through them.
See, all's fair in love and war and getting a job. And so if you have to parachute down, if you have to submarine up, if you have to go in the back door, the side door, whatever door you have to go in, you have to get in front of a potential employer.
I think what we're going to do in here today is review the staff meeting that we had the last time with the customer.
Sure. Go over the product features.
Absolutely.
Consulting is one way to get in the door. And the doors open more easily when you're offering valuable advice for free.
The theory for our group is that if we give them 10 or 12 hours of free consultation, then somehow it can benefit them, keeps our skills honed, and by the same token, it might evolve into some kind of a relationship.
Nice to see you again.
Good to see you.
It was an offer Innovative Cellular Technologies of Lowell couldn't refuse. They knew they needed help.
We've come up with a preliminary report that we want to share with you.
The Merrimack Valley Consultants Group was an opportunity that came knocking.
We have a set of individuals who are highly skilled professionals who are willing to come in and give you some free consultation.
So it might lead to something permanent for you at some point.
We'll see.
Like the other members of the group, Marion Cacus Young should be at the peak of her profession. Highly skilled, career-oriented, her resume includes years of experience with Raytheon and digital. Unemployed for a year now, she's determined to work again.
And as long as I remain undaunted, I'm all set. You know, as long as I don't run out of money for the stamps and the money for the phones and various other things. I'm all set.
The pursuit, says outplacement specialist Barry Bograd, is not getting any easier, especially if it's permanent employment you're after.
Companies want to just pay for the service and then see you later. We'll call you when we need you. We'll turn you on and off.
Virtually all the increase in employment that has occurred in the country over the last year has been in the temporary employment area.
But today, people are realizing that temps perform a lot more than just clerical skills. What we found out is that companies today no longer just use temporaries to fill people out on vacation. When there's a special project, people hire temp agencies, and people really use us for expertise.
MacTemps of Cambridge specializes in computer-skilled temporary professionals. Rachel Felter is one.
You pretty much need to have computer skills to get office jobs like this, because most offices are on computer to some extent or another.
Skill is exactly why Rachel has this temporary position at the MIT Center for Transportation Studies. And it's a work style she's chosen so she can pursue her first love, music.
As long as you have the skills, you will have job security and you will get paid well.
Agencies like MacTemps have also introduced health, vacation, and retirement plans to draw more qualified people into the temp force. If there's one message we've heard over and over again, it is if you're going to make it in the workplace of the 90s, you have to be creative. and you have to be prepared to sell yourself. In other words, all of us are going to have to be a little more entrepreneurial.
The average age of our student is 47.
These are some of Gary Cogley's students. They've seen their jobs disappear, and now they're trying to act on their dreams of business ownership. Like Robert Thomas, who lost his 15-year job with Kodak. He's trying to build an ethnic greeting card business.
As an entrepreneur, you can take your life and make out of it what you want to make out of it.
Paula Wheeldon, formerly with the Wang Corporation, has designed software application to help police reduce paperwork.
Alcohol? Evidence? Two empty cans? Beer.
A typical report like this will take half an hour to 45 minutes to an hour to do in the station. We've done this in less than a minute.
The corporate lifestyle isn't for a lot of the people in my generation. I don't think it's so much that they don't want to work. I just think that they know, you know, corporate America is not working anymore. And my reaction to that was to start my own business.
Alex Rogliotti opens a brewery next year. In its first year, the Central Massachusetts Entrepreneurial Center in Marlborough has graduated 129 entrepreneurs and generated 55 operating businesses.
Some people have such a passion for it, and they just blossom. And those are the folks that create the businesses in this country.
Gee, good things can come out of rough
times. That's right. Gary Cogley actually predicts there are going to be a lot of new businesses, Mary, that are going to result from the troubles. You know, the good things can come out of adversity, certainly. In fact, that the police reporting software we saw is already in use at the Acton police station.
That's
so those
great
folks
idea.
Have found a gold in some sense of the word.
And we'll have more of Chronicle right after this. Coming up next, white collars, blue collars, no collars.
Everybody has a brain, and they're grown-ups. So why should some people do the thinking and the other people just be hands and feet?
Anyone can see that the new GE Profile Radiant Convection Range is easy to clean, but the real technological advantage is what you can't see. So we'll show it to you in a roundabout way. Introducing the first GE range that circulates hot air all around your food, roasting meats up to 30% faster so they get done to a turn on the outside while staying tender and juicy on the inside. Why does GE offer such an ingenious way to cook? Because we know how much of life revolves around dinner.
It's amazing how much of my life is work. Although I've learned some shortcuts, today I've got a very important project, big interview tomorrow. Gotta go to Marshall's. I need the perfect outfit. This wasn't here last week. Professional, self-assured, but with a little personality. Not to mention fiscally conservative. I saw this at a department store for $150 more. That was easy.
Channel 5 salutes the employees at Boston Edison. Your United Way contributions help the Salvation Army. United Way of Mass Bay. Because of you, it's working.
Up next, of pedals and metals.
Even though the Honda Accord has been one of the best-selling cars in America, we thought it was time to make a few changes. Like more interior space, dual airbags, better performance, and all-new styling. The 1994 Accord DX sedan. Basically, Honda changed everything. But the price.
I turned to my husband and I said, Carl, did you know I was fat? And he said, babe, you're just pleasingly plump. I went to Jenny Craig because of the food. Jenny's Cuisine taught me what a healthy portion was. It's not just prepackaged food. You eat lots of fresh produce. And before you know it, you're no longer eating Jenny's food. You've learned how to cook for yourself. Now my husband says he can pick me up again and I don't break his back now.
Instead of just another diet, get personal weight management at Jenny Craig, all for just $1 a pound. Call 1-800-92-JENNY.
Today's 20-somethings face fewer choices in the workplace than their counterparts did even 10 years ago. Corporations aren't hiring or paying the way they once did.
If there's one generation that's had to totally rethink its dreams, it's the one caught between 80s excess and 90s reality.
The point is, ladies and gentlemen, that greed, for lack of a better word, is good. Greed is right.
At least that was the prevailing attitude during the 1980s, when the lure of Wall Street was irresistible for 20-somethings like Ashley Kornblatt.
Well, when I graduated from business school, everybody, it was in the middle of the 80s, and everybody was going to Wall Street. And they were recruiting really heavily, and you had to be insane not to go. And everyone's plan was to go and make millions of dollars and then become an entrepreneur after they'd made their first $3 million in 3 years, no problem.
She didn't make $3 million, and she didn't last 3 years. But having escaped the crash of 1987, she has become an entrepreneur. Ashley is president of Merlin Metalworks, a small business in Cambridge that manufactures $4,000 bikes. Everything about Merlin, from its product to its management style, to the people who've landed jobs here, make it a very 1990s kind of company. The bikes are made of titanium, an incredibly lightweight and durable metal alloy developed by the aerospace and defense industries. It's a difficult material to work with, and it's expensive. Scott Spence used to be a titanium welder at GE in Lynn before defense downsizing hit him back in 89. He figured he'd never find any welding job, much less the highly specialized type of welding he was doing for GE.
I think my job security here at Merlin is very good. We have a lot of good ideas. The company's heading in the right direction, and that's part of the reason why I've stayed here and worked so hard at this company.
Loyalty is one result of an increasingly popular management style called the flat company. It does away with middle managers and empowers workers to have a say in the operation.
Everybody has a brain, and they're grown-ups. So why should some people do the thinking and the other people just be hands and feet? It doesn't make any sense. Anybody who wants to think about the problems, I'm thrilled to have them thinking about them.
When I worked at GE, there was management and your blue-collar worker. Where here at Merlin, we have company meetings and everybody has a say in what goes on here.
Employee motivation is the fuel that drives small businesses like Merlin, and that, according to many economists, could help turn the economy around. In fact, it's estimated 90% of most of the new jobs in this country come from small business. It's not hard to see why small companies are the hope of the future. For one thing, they seem to get things done a lot more efficiently.
Being able to change and meet the customer's demands, which are constantly changing, is critical. And the smaller you are, the faster you can do that.
I think you're going to have, I see it in the software business right now, a lot of small companies, a lot of entrepreneurial ventures where people really are significant cogs in the wheels and they're not numbers. And I think that's the way business is going to go. And it's going to be exciting. But there's going to be shakeouts because not every small company can make it.
But for all the promise that small business holds, some experts warn not to think of it as an economic cure-all.
The issue is not big versus small. The issue is having the right mix. Big companies do R&D. Big companies pay high wages. Big companies can export. Small companies are important if they grow to be big companies. But a small company that remains a small company is not much interest to the economy.
What is of interest to the economy, according to Professor Thoreau, are several key industries that will be crucial in the next decade. Biotechnology, microelectronics, and telecommunications. These high-tech businesses have already spawned a wave of startup companies and will continue to absorb skilled workers let go elsewhere. And again, the emphasis is on skills and being willing to change with these turbulent times.
They live and you got to function in an uncertain world. You're going to have to be able to operate much more on your own. That is, you're going to have to be able to interact much more just based on what your own skills are.
The skills that you're going to have to know are continually changing. Unless you can keep up with that, you'll be in trouble.
Chronicle will return after these messages and tonight's winning lottery number.
Please pass the all fruit.
Pass the Polaner all fruit.
Pass the Polaner all fruit.
Would you please pass the jelly?
Polaner all fruit is real fruit, sweetened only with fruit juice and no added sugar. You'll call it delicious. You'll call it remarkable. Mm. But please, don't dare call it jelly. Polaner all fruit, the spreadable fruit.
This is the all-new 1994 Mitsubishi Galant. It has a longer wheelbase than the Camry. More headroom and hip room. Plus, the Galant gives you 11 more horses under the hood. But there is one place the new Galant is smaller than the Camry. At least $2,300 smaller.
Test drive the all-new Galant at your New England area Mitsubishi Motors dealer today.
We know the importance of treating you as an individual. That's why we designed the Max Account. It's a practical, flexible bank account that works uniquely for everyone. It's just another way that Bank of Boston is there to help you out. Hey, Jack, wake up. You're going to be late. The Max Account from the bank that's listening. Okay, five more minutes. Bank of Boston.
Hey, wait for me. Oh, ow. Oh, what's that? Oh, fruit drink. Good, but it needs something. Oh, yeah. I'll just roll this in here.
New apple quenchers from Verifine. Great tasting fruit, first quenching apples.
Uh-oh.
Nothing quenches like apple quenchers.
If you want to be in a position of power, then get behind the wheel of a 1994 Jeep Grand Cherokee V8. With a powerful 220 horsepower engine, 6,500 pound towing capacity, standard driver's side airbag, and four-wheel anti-lock brakes, it lets you command power in any situation. The Jeep Grand Cherokee V8, the only thing more powerful is the savings.
See your New England Jeep and Eagle dealer now.
That's our program for this evening. Tomorrow night, the two finalists for mayor of Boston face off in the first major televised debate since last week's primary election. The topic, Boston schools. We'll find out how Tom Menino and Jim Brett plan to handle public education.
And later tonight on News Center 5, the latest on the murder of Boston Police Detective John Mulligan and Connecticut's push to lure the New England Patriots out of Massachusetts. Is it gaining ground? Thanks for being with us tonight. I'm Mary Richardson.
And I'm Peter Mahigan. Join us for the debate tomorrow night. Good night.
Good night.